Yeah, I decided to sort of leave this little end bit here. Not sure why. Might be a bit unprofessional, but then again, I by no means a professional access. I am a professional author, and even then, I am a bit of a sarcastic with that. But alas, in regards to this, I mean, I don't want to be stupid. But if you're looking at this expecting any sort of severe, not even he knows quality control, just he knows what he's doing, you're gonna be disappointed. Because for one, I am playing a lot of games that I'm just simply unfamiliar with. This game is one of them. This is not necessarily a blind playthrough, but I did not grow up with this game as a child. I wasn't even aware, or at least did not notice this game as a kid, and just due to my sort of mature attitude back then. Even if I were to see this game at a, say, Blockbuster or rental store, despite me liking it now, I probably wouldn't have given it a fair chance. Because just due to my sort of low self-esteem issues at the time, and like, I didn't want to play anything that would have been considered catered towards kids. So because of the sort of kid-like appeal and packaging of this game, I wouldn't have given it any fair deal. Now, if someone were to, say, buy this thing around Christmas or, Thanksgiving, Christmas or birthday gift or what have you, I'd be extremely disappointed at first. Though I will not voice my disappointment, I will attempt to show some sort of gratitude to the thing for buying me this gift. But if, you know, once I were to have hooked it up to my console and started playing back in my immature to kind of play kid-like games, I was really enjoyable. But I first of all had to have gotten it. And I will have never simply but ask for this game. Which is a shame, I know. Now, unfortunately, that's how I was back in my young man. Oh well. Saying that, I did complete this game once when I got it for my PS3 collection. This game is very enjoyable, but I've only played this game once. And a lot of the games that I'm playing play through once, or especially in regards to SNES games, definitely almost did not grow up because I did not know this early Genesis as a kid, not a Super Nintendo. A lot of the games I'm going through them are just based on my past experience with. So again, if you're looking for anybody who knows what they're doing, you're gonna be disappointed. And even the games I do have experience with, I'm looking specifically at Sonic 2 and Shinobi, it has been a very long time since I've played any sort of shooting platform recently due to the fact that the sort of the way games have evolved since my youth. So yeah. And also the Quintet, I believe it is, Quintet Trilogy. I said it in my... I've said it in that playlist, I'll say it again here. I did not grow up, not only did I just simply not grow up with a Super Nintendo, but my... just in general... experience with... action adventure 2D anyways, action adventure games. I'm not actually saying my game, I have no experience at all, basically. I've completed Illusion of Gaia once. And that was long enough to go for me to simply kind of forget what comes next, more or less. So there's going to be a point where I go, oh fuck, I have no idea what to do now. And the other games I'm going to check out for the trilogy, like, I have very little, if any, experience in those games because I really did not grow up with them, and in regards to a lot of them, this simply doesn't like them. I am going to be honest with you, by the way, this glitch. This is a glitch. I do not like 2D Zelda. And it's probably because I simply did not grow up with 2D Zelda. But even the more or less modern 2D Zelda games, I'm just simply not a fan of, so in regards to that whole action adventure role playing genre, I am simply not a big fan. Yet. Anyways, I do feel like adding in that yet. Because now that I'm playing the Quintet Trilogy, dabbled a little bit on Twitch with Secret of Mana. Those games I really do, I actually do like. I think it's due to the more linear variety. You know, something like Zelda, something like Zelda where you have a more or less open world and you have to travel, you don't know specifically where to go. That really rubs me the wrong way, which is weird because in something like a Japanese role, turn-based role-playing game. That doesn't bother me at all. But in something like Zelda, it does, and it's... I'm not entirely sure why. I'm really not. But anyways, yeah, what I'm trying to say is, I am, even as a noob, damn it, someone's calling me, I don't know who it is, and I don't really want to speak to him. How long have I been recording? You know what, I'm gonna end it.